All right, welcome back here. Another day on aviation restoration, or should I say Aerostar restoration, as we bring this Aerostar that has not flown in 17 years back to life. Today, I got to finish fixing that front chair, which would not slide forward to allow people to board into the back. As you might be able to see, it does slide forward now, but I have to finish the screws. Then we're going to give it some power. This thing has not seen electricity maybe in 17 years. The battery's certainly dead, so we're going to plug it in and see what fires up and what doesn't. Let's give it a go. All right, so I was working last time. I got this to slide forward and backwards, but I dropped the washer, and there it is. Okay, so I got to retrieve that washer and then tighten these screws, and we can call this job done. Lift the back out, line it up, lift it all out. There's the washer. I will say for me, the smell of a 1970s interior does take away a tad from the joy of flying. Wouldn't mind, oh yeah, all that stuff I dropped. Wouldn't mind having the smell of a nice leather interior instead. All right, so this is a binder I built for a original large format POH from the 1970s. So what we're looking here now is we're gonna try and give this power. This is a dead battery, but it has a ground power plug in the back. What a day. All right, I'm going to get in the cockpit. Let me know when it's connected. I'll turn the battery on. We'll see if it works. All right, let's see what happens here. All right, electricity is some things. I'm going to run the flaps to see if the flaps work. Oh. Kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it, kill it. Smoke coming from something.
Uh-oh.
That's what was smoking in here. It was coming from the top. It was coming seemingly out of here. I wouldn't even know. See, when I press the brake pedals, there's definitely there's some pressure. I don't know what it should be. But more importantly, I could tell that the right has significantly less pressure than the left. So I'm pressing the right brake pedal and the left brake pedal with the same pressure at the same time. And I get much less resistance on the right. That means that has to open and we need to top off hydraulics in both of these. All right, so here in the Aerostar is a forward hatch. There is two hydraulics reservoirs as well as potentially avionics bay. I'm not clear on that last part. I want to get in here, just really check the hydraulic reservoirs and see where that stands. It was taped. Oh yeah, all right. No, at least I can mount that back on and take it back off. Oh, there's some here. All right, so this one reads pretty good. It's well above the add line near the full line. All right, so this is interesting. When we gave a ground power, we put the flaps down. Worked fine. Hopefully none of the electrical issues had anything to do with the flaps, but those work great. I just pulled from the hydraulic reservoir here, I pulled a dipstick. And when I did so, I realized that there's no hydraulic fluid. Now, I know you could see a little bit there at the end, but that's really because I held it upside down. It was just the very bottom tip, which as you could see, if you can see, get better light on it, is well below the line there that says low. It's basically empty. And as I was coming over to get the camera to show you guys, I noticed something. My droopy gear doors are closed, at least on this side. Now, I had assumed that the gear door being low when it was drooping was because it needed the hydraulic system to be cycled and build up some pressure again. And apparently lowering the flaps may have accomplished that. So let's go look on the other side. But if we come, oh, look, we had an asymmetric flap deployment. Okay. Left flap is all the way down, right flap is not. But the door is closed. And again, we're out of hydraulic fluids. I have the first evidence here of any type. What may be mice. I don't smell any mice. It doesn't smell like mice. Let's pull this out carefully. All right, so here's what I've been working on here. So this panel underneath here is there's the two autopilot servos, and there's also a fuel cross feed to get from tank A, left and right, into the center tank that's right here. Up top is the oxygen cylinder that obviously is going to need to be at the very least serviced, if not replaced outright. On this side, lots of stuff back here. So here's the hydraulic system here. That's a heater back there with 330 hours on the clock. In the back, way back there, is the battery. We're going to do that next. You can definitely start to see now. All right, with that panel up, you can fit two full-size suitcases in here and then a lot more on top of it. I'm going to call it a night. Please like and subscribe. See you next time.